Hi folks, it's Professor Allen here, your favorite gemologist. Welcome back to GemU. Today I'm going to give you a lesson about tourmaline, which is one of October's birthstones. I've gotten a lot of messages, a lot of questions from my students. I'm here to answer them. Let's get started, it's going to be exciting.
Professor Allen, why do tourmalines come in so many different colors?
That's a great question. Tourmaline has a base as nature forms it, and its base stone is boron silicate aluminum. That's the base, and then nature introduces a mineral trace element that gives it its color. For instance, in the green family, where you have the deep, rich forest green and minty green, she puts in vanadium and chromium that gives it the green color. Then there's Potaiba tourmaline, and it gets that glow. That Potaiba has a burst of bright, bright color and glow, and that is copper. Copper gives it that wonderful, wonderful color. Then you come to two important gemstones. At one end of the spectrum is the blue. At the opposite end of the spectrum is rubellite, ruby hue or ruby tone. Rubellite, rare and beautiful. The deeper the blue at one end of the spectrum comes from iron, and the deeper the blue, the more rare. At the other end, when we're working with rubellite, she puts in manganese, and it gives it that beautiful, the rubellite has that red, rich color. Gorgeous. Simply put, nature works from the base by adding those different mineral trace elements to give tourmaline that rainbow of color and that excitement that makes tourmaline so popular.
Professor Allen, what tourmaline colors are the best and most valuable?
That's an interesting question. What's the best and most valuable? I think the best is your taste, what you like, the color that's your favorite. For instance, the pink tourmaline, that lush, bright pink, women adore it. It means success and love, the lore. All tourmaline falls under that category. But the ones that are most sought after is the blue in the indicolite and the red in the rubellite, because they're rare, and the deeper the color, the better the quality. They have to be cut well, they have to be clean, free of inclusions, and deep, rich color. That blue has to be a rich, vibrant blue, and the red in the rubellite has to stand out. But when it comes to the king of tourmalines, far and away, is the Potaiba, because of its color, that bluish green or greenish blue. And it's an electric stone. You have to see it to believe it. There's an inner glow because of the copper, and it's bright, and it commands and demands your attention. You can't take your eyes off it. That is the king of tourmalines, and the value is there.
Professor Allen, what is a visual phenomenon of tourmaline?
Great technical question. Tourmaline is a plechroic stone. What does that mean? It means that any of the colors you have in that stone, as you move it, right to left, up or down, one part of the stone will be a little deeper in its color or tone, the other one a little lighter. That's inherent in tourmaline. I don't care what color it is. The ones that show it the most, if it's emerald cut or step cut, the rounds, the pear shapes, the ovals, don't exhibit it. But the emerald cut, and it's cut most in an emerald cut because the way it forms in nature, in a long bar effect. So the emerald cut, it's just cut more often that way. As you move it, regardless of the color, one part may be a little deeper in its color and the other just a shade lighter in its color. And as that movement goes, that tone changes. Very romantic and very unique to see. The other one is the cat's eye tourmaline, or chatoyancy. And that's when the cutter, he rounds the stone out, and it has to contain rutile crystal. The rutile crystal has to be aligned next to one another, and he orients it so it's north-south. And when that happens, and he rounds it out, that line in the dead center goes from one side of the stone over the top, the cabochon, down to the other side. Sometimes it's referred to as a knife edge, distinct line It is beautiful. And as the stone moves, that line moves a little bit until it's oriented right in the center. That's called cat's eye or chatoyancy, a rare phenomena that happens in tourmaline. It's exciting when it happens.
Professor Allen, how would you rate the durability of tourmaline jewelry?
Good question, an excellent question. It's a safe question. How do I rate the durability of tourmaline? It's rated a 7 to 7.5 on the Mohn scale of hardness. That's a very durable stone, from 1 to 10, 1 being talc, the powder, and 10 being your diamond. So 7, 7.5 is a very durable, safe stone to wear. Never take any of your stones, diamond, sapphires, down to tourmaline, for granted because of their hardness. Respect them. If you have a jewelry box, separate them. Give them a little breathing space between one another. And it's safe to wear. Wear them often, that's why you have them. Folks, we provide a variety of tourmaline jewelry at Gem Shopping Network. You can discover them when watching us 24/7 live shows at the link below. If you have any more questions, go to the comment section below and hit the subscribe button so you can keep up with Gem U lessons. It's important. I hope you learned a lot today. Thanks for watching. Please go in good health.